Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to transform a photo of a face into a tremendous granite rock sculpture. For your convenience, I provided a Photoshop template that you can download so you can follow along. Its link is in my video's description or project files. It includes two layers, a seascape background and granite texture. We'll use the granite texture later, so temporarily hide it by clicking the eyeball icon next to it. Keep in mind, you can use your own background if you like. However, if you do, make its resolution 150 pixels per inch. You can check it by going to Image and Image Size. If it's not 150 pixels per inch, just type it in and click OK. Before we begin, if you're not already a subscriber to Blue Lightning TV, click the small subscribe button at the lower right corner to let you know as soon as I upload new Photoshop tutorials. If my tutorials have helped you learn or improve in Photoshop, or inspired you to explore your creativity, please consider becoming a patron to my channel for as little as $2 per month. You can cancel it whenever you want, or choose to continue to support my channel for as long as you like. Open a focused close-up of a person's face that you'd like to turn into stone. I downloaded this one from Shutterstock. The results will look best if the face is lighted at an angle so there's more shadow on one side of the face. Make a copy of it by pressing Ctrl or Command J so we always have the original as is. If the shadow is hiding too much detail on the face, we can brighten the darkest areas by going to Image, Adjustments, and Shadows Highlights. Drag the Shadows Amount slider all the way to the left to bring it back to its original look, and slowly drag it to the right until you begin to see just the right amount of detail in the shadows. We'll isolate our subject's head from the rest of the photo by making a selection around the head. There are many ways to do this, and I cover them all in my tutorials. For this example, I'll use the Pen tool to draw paths around the head. If you're using this tool as well, I did an in-depth tutorial showing you how to use it. That link is in my video's description as well. Once you made a completed path around the head, right-click or secondary click directly on the path and click Make Selection. Feather it 1 or 2 pixels. Go to Select, Modify, and Contract. Contract it 1 pixel. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection. Hide the original layer to see how the head looks without its background. To place the head onto the seascape or onto another background of your choice, press V on your keyboard to open your Move tool and drag it onto the tab of your background. Without releasing your mouse or pen, drag it down and release. To resize it, press Ctrl or Command T to open your Transform tool. Go to a corner of the bounding box, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift and drag the bounding box in or out. If you're using CC 2019 or later, just press Alt or Option as you drag it. To reposition it, go inside the bounding box and drag it to a position you like. Then press Enter or Return. Desaturate the head by pressing Ctrl or Command Shift U. If the lighting on the head is opposite from the source of lighting on your background, you can either flip the head or flip the background by going to Edit, Transform, and Flip Horizontal. Next, we'll create a displacement map of the head that we'll use to wrap the stone texture around. To do this, first, temporarily hide the background and click the icon at the upper right corner. Click Duplicate Layer. When you see this window, open the destination document list and click New. Type in Displacement and click OK. Immediately, it created a new document called Displacement. Displacement maps look best when they're slightly blurred, so go back to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 4 pixels. Go to File and Save As. Save it to your desktop as a Photoshop PSD file and click Save. If you see this message, just click OK. Open back the template document. We'll convert the head into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively. To do this, click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. Go to Filter, Noise, and Median. Make the radius 10 pixels. To save some space in the Layers panel, let's collapse the filter effect. Go to the texture and drag it above the head. Make it visible and change its blend mode to overlay. We'll reduce the size of the texture to fit the head by opening the transform tool. Size the texture so it's just outside the perimeter of the head. Go to Filter, Distort, and Displace. Type in 5 for the horizontal and vertical scales, and tick Stretch to Fit and Repeat Edge Pixels. Click the Displacement PSD document that you saved and click Open. The texture immediately made a subtle shift based on the tonal values of the head. We'll mask out the texture outside the head by control-clicking or command-clicking the head to make a selection of its shape. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to the texture. Next, we'll adjust the head's tones. Make Layer 1 active and click the Adjustment Layer icon. Click Curves. Adjustment layers affect all the layers below them in the Layers panel. However, if you want an adjustment layer to restrict itself to affect just one layer below it, click the Clipping Mask icon or press Alt-Control-G on Windows or Option-Command-G on a Mac. You can also go to Layer and create Clipping Mask. The Curves adjustment layer essentially allows you to adjust an image's tonal range. Initially, the image's tonality is represented as a straight diagonal line on a graph. The upper right represents the highlights, the middle represents the midtones, and the lower left represents the shadows. By clicking and dragging the line to different points in the grid, you're essentially adjusting the brightness of the specific tone you're dragging. To remove a control point, you can drag it off the graph, or select it and press Delete, or control-click or command-click the control point. If you want to get rid of all the control points that you moved and start fresh, click this icon. For this particular image, I'll drag the shadows up to here to brighten them, and the midtones down to here to darken them. Feel free to experiment with it. You can always go back and change it later. We'll place all of the layers that comprise our head into a folder. To do this, make the texture layer active and shift-click the head layer to make all the layers in between active. Then, press Ctrl or Command-G. Name it Head. Make the background active and convert it into a smart object. Let's make the background smoother and give it a painterly, ethereal quality. To do this, go to Filter, Stylize, and Oil Paint. Make the stylization 1.5, the cleanliness 10, the scale 0.1, and the bristle detail 10. Make sure lighting is unchecked. Let's collapse the filter to save more space in the Layers panel. Click the Adjustment Layer icon and click Black and White. I did an in-depth tutorial of the black and white filter, so if you'd like to watch it, I provided its link as well. Essentially, this adjustment layer makes your image appear in grayscale and allows you to adjust the brightness and darkness of individual colors as they appear in grayscale. To adjust a particular color component, click this icon and then click on the image. Drag right or left to modify the color slider for the predominant color at that location, making it darker or brighter in the grayscale image. If you're using this Seascape photo, type in the following amounts. For reds, type in 46, yellows, 60, greens, 40, cyans, 60, blues, minus 150, and magentas, 60. Next, we'll add a filter that will give our image a surreal cinematic look. Make the head folder active and click the adjustment layer icon. Click Color Lookup. Open the Load 3D LUT list and click Late Sunset.3DL. Reduce the opacity to 60%. Next, we'll brush in a highlight over the edge of the face to give it more depth. Open the head folder and make the texture active. Make a new layer above it and name it Sun Glow. Change the blend mode to Soft Light. Go to the layer mask and press and hold Alt or Option as you drag a copy of the layer mask next to the Sun Glow layer. The layer mask will keep the glow inside the edges of the head. We want white to be our foreground color, so if the foreground and background colors are inverted, revert them back by pressing X on your keyboard. Open your brush tool and brush picker. Make its size 60 pixels, the hardness 0%, and the opacity and flow 100%. Then press Enter or Return. Brush over the edge of the head, but avoid the chin and the top of the head. Lastly, we'll add the shadow at the bottom. Close the head folder and make the background active. Make a new layer above it and name it Shadow. Invert the colors and brush a horizontal line approximately this long. Click the layer mask icon to make a layer mask next to the shadow. Brush arcs over the corners to narrow them. Change its blend mode to Soft Light and reduce its opacity to 50%. Make a copy of it and change its blend mode to Hard Light and its opacity to 40%. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.